Greetings, adventurers. Don here of Mystic Sword Gaming, along with Dee, the very cute game master. Say hi, Dee.
Hello, I'm circling around you again.
So, you know what? Now that we have a fire going here, I think I have some carrots I should cook.
Yeah, you should cook those. I'm going to start gathering... Oh, we caught a rabbit. Excellent.
Oh, did we?
Yeah, he's right here.
Very cool.
So I'll bring you... I'll murder him. It says murder when you find...
Oh!
So you should catch... So this one triggered, too. So open that up, and you'll get the rabbit.
Okay, inspect.
Yep.
I am adept at weaving. Okay, check.
All right, and you got that rabbit.
And oh,
then
yes,
if
I
you
do.
Hover over it...
Yes. Murder.
Yes.
Oh, I don't like that. It makes you feel guilty.
Yeah, and then you can cook it, and you'll have a morsel to eat. So if you hovered a piece over
the fire. Well, I'm a robot. It's nutrients. Okay, I'm sorry, rabbit.
And the nice thing about the trap is, even though it's gone down in durability, you can just reset it over a hole, like so.
Now, I'm assuming that the cooked rabbit gives you a good amount of hunger level back?
Yes.
Which I should do now, because mine's down to about a quarter.
Yeah, you should. We should start making more traps, too, and we should start also spearheading the refining of raw materials effort, because as you know, if you go next to your science machine, there's a lot of cool stuff you can make, and we're going to need that stuff fairly soon. There's a Thermaster, there's a wall, I don't think we need... Ooh, this will be good for us. Here's a chest.
when I was editing my side of the recording last time, I noticed there's, under survival, there's something called the Telltale Heart. And you were saying about you haven't played Don't Starve Together much.
Mm-hmm.
And you said something like when your friend dies, you're not sure how to bring them back. But there's something there I noticed that says the Telltale Heart. And it says a ghastly revival of a ghostly friend.
Oh, so that could be it, actually. Yeah, that sounds like it could be it.
It's right before the rabbit trap.
Okay. All right, I'm just
going to... Speaking of which, I'm going to build a rabbit trap.
Okay. I'm going to pick some more stuff. We need to start getting a steady food supply. I've noticed that even though there's a bunch of beefalo up here, and they're a little tough for us, it's not going to be very... We just need more stuff, pretty much. Oh, also about the beefalo, there's just a little bit of warning I should tell you about. So during the summer, it is mating season for these guys, and you'll notice that their hindquarters become a little pinkish.
Okay.
I suggest don't go so close to them during that period, because they become aggressive.
They're in the mating heat. Or whatever.
Exactly. So, yeah, that probably wouldn't be a good idea. So I'm just going to start setting a bunch of rabbit traps out.
Now, I noticed, maybe you did something when I wasn't paying attention. Up at our campfire by the science machine, there's a chest here now. Did you put that there?
Yes. So you can make chests. So we don't have much inventory space, if you've noticed.
Oh, so we can store stuff in it.
Exactly. And we can make multiple chests, too, if we need more storage room.
Okay, well, I'm going to put some stuff in there. I think I have a couple of gold nuggets and things like that.
Yeah, the gold nuggets won't be useful until... I better get back to camp soon. They won't be useful until we... I think gold nuggets, you can use them to make an alchemy machine, which is the next step up of the science prototype.
Okay. I'm happen to notice now... I guess this is normal... I see these big shapes moving around, like just out of the range of the campfire glow.
Oh, what's your sanity meter looking like?
Oh, yeah, you're right. It's down to about half.
All right, so in the morning, we'll go out and pick some flowers.
Okay, I have 5 flowers.
All right, can you make another garland for yourself? You need 10, I think.
Let me see. Garland, I think it says here 12.
Okay, so we're going to need to pick more flowers for you. And I should put more stuff in the fire. It's getting a little low.
Oh, no. There's a pair of eyes. Do you see it?
No. So when your sanity meter... Actually, unequip this garland, and I'm going to let you wear it.
Because
my sanity meter is all the way full to the top.
Well, that's very kind of you.
So, yeah. So, that's the other aspect of the game. Remember how I said there was, like, magic and all that other good stuff? So, we kind of came here by supernatural means. And unlike me, you do not have a glorious beard.
Well, right now, I see there's, like, these big, hulking, monster-like shapes all around me. And there's something up here. It looks like some kind of hideous scarecrow creature.
Okay, but so when your
it just went away.
Yeah, when your sanity gets low enough, you're gonna start seeing things like you just saw. Those monsters actually provide some materials for the later game. Like I think there's like the shadow ectoplasma. They can drop to make better weapons and such. It's always, when you get later game, you kind of want to reach that sanity point where you can actually see the creatures and then you can actually try to, hurt them. I'm just going up north to try to find something to eat because I'm getting hungry and I didn't see our traps had triggered anything yet. So I'm up here just trying to find berries and things of that nature. So I just went way north. And I do not see anything. So I might have to jump down that wormhole. Oh, there's something to the east. There's wooded area to the east. So that would be good. Yes, I know I'm hungry. My character just said he was hungry. I know I'm hungry. I'm working on it.
Yeah, I'm hungry too, but luckily I just found a couple of carrots.
That's good. All right, so.
And I've been picking a bunch more flowers.
Oh yeah, and the birch nut trees have seeds, so that would be a good steady food supply. So I should cut some of those down too, just to make sure we have something to eat.
Oh yeah, you can eat the seeds as well, right?
Yeah. All right, so let me know if you start hearing growling besides your stomach.
Okay.
Because...
You need a carrot? I have two carrots.
I got some nuts, so I can cook those soon. But, so, I think it's after day 10 that goblin dogs are going to start coming after us. And you know they're coming by the sound they make. They'll make like a snorting type of sound. And once you hear the snorting, you know they're close by. They're not exactly in proximity of us. So we should prototype some spears soon so we can fight them. Also prototype is a set of wooden armor for us.
Okay, so what do we need to make a spear?
Just flint and sticks, but you just need to prototype it next to the machine.
Okay, and I guess you need some kind of rope, too?
Yeah, I think you might need rope. I would double check with that. I've already started refining rope, so we should be okay on the rope front as long as there is a steady supply of grass around us.
Oh, there you are.
Yep, sorry about that. I'm just chopping up these trees. Up, need a new axe. Just gotta build another one. There we go.
So cooking the seeds make them more nutritious, maybe?
You cannot eat the seeds without cooking them, because I guess they're in a hard shell or something of that nature.
Really?
Maybe
because I'm a robot.
Maybe, because when I hover over mine, it just says examine. I can't eat it.
No, so, I'm able to eat them.
Oh, okay, good on you. I guess being metal helps somewhat. We should also start looking for spiders. Spiders provide silk, and if it rains, it's not going to be a good time for you.
So something that the spider can give you provides... You can make an umbrella, you were saying?
Yes, you can make an umbrella.
Okay, so are we going to camp by this campfire for the night, or what are we doing here?
We can camp. I can't carry any more stuff, so I gotta cook some more nuts, and I gotta drop some logs onto this fire. We should just keep on working on getting materials. This is a decent area to get food. I need to eat a little more. There we go. This is a pretty decent area to get food. We might also consider not cooking all the birch nuts so we can have a steady supply of nuts next to camp, because we can plant the seeds that will eventually become trees for us.
Now, I have enough flowers, I can make another garland, so I'm going to do that, and then I'll give you one back.
All right, that sounds wonderful. I would love a garland of flowers.
Okay. Here you go.
Thank you.
A gift from me to you.
All right, I will put that on. Yay. I feel like a hippie.
You're so pretty. I'm so pretty. Oh, berries. Oh, where'd they come from?
Oh, they were from that bush. I couldn't carry anymore. And that's exactly why we need a chest. So let me cook these.
Oops, I meant to cook it and he ate them.
Yeah, it's all right. How's your hunger meter currently?
Around quarter.
Okay. Oh, like 3/4 full or only a quarter?
Well, I just ate a couple things, so now it's closer to half.
Okay, cool. All right. Here, you can have these.
But I just ate everything. Actually, it gives me the option to eat the flowers, too.
I think those only bring back your health. I think at one point I dropped some nuts next to you, so you can grab some of you can eat those if you want, and we will.
Oh, thank you.
No problem at all. But yeah, my meter is 3/4 of the way full, so we should be okay. What else can we make? We can make a grass suit. The spear does require sticks, one coil of rope, and one flint. And the sleep dart, we can't get feathers. More grass. And
so where do we find the spiders, or do they only come out at night?
So the spiders will congregate around what looks like a big mound of webs. And if we get close, they will show up. So you better get fire. Don?
Oh, yeah.
Don, where are you?
Yeah, it got dark all of a sudden. I was chopping a tree and then it just like went pitch black.
All right, I need to prototype a shovel. So these, another useful thing you can do if you don't want to keep on wandering away from the campsite is you can dig up the grass and the berry bushes and the sticks, and you can carry them into your inventory, and you can replant them, and with some manure they'll keep on respawning resources for us. Don?
Yep, I'm here.
Please don't go in the dark. The dark is bad.
Well, I seen something I could grab, so I grabbed it. here we are.
Woo! Woo!
All morning! Right. Glorious morning!
Okay, and then we... Uh-oh.
Yeah, that stage of night, it gets, like, really dark.
If you go into the dark and you stay down there long enough, there's something that comes and gets you eventually. Like, just...
Well, I seen the pair of eyes earlier, so...
It gets really, really, really creepy, too. Oh, no. What do we do?
Actually, it says here, protective branches detect it.
Oh,
so
okay.
If I stand under the tree, it might provide me a bit of cover, apparently.
Okay, that's good. That's very good. But you're
because
getting...
Because when it started raining, it said detective branches detected or something. Yeah.
All right. I'm going to plant... I plant, not drop. I want to plant this.
So when it rains, typically, how long does it stay raining?
It stays raining a lot. So,
oh, no.
Yeah, so I'm going to... Oh, jeez. All right, what do we do? I've never been in this situation before. The other thing that stinks is that our stuff in our inventory will become waterlogged. That might not be great. So, okay, I'm gonna search for more food. I should be fine in the rain.
Well, what happens to me? Do I just freeze up or die or what?
I'm not sure. So this rain is new in the Giant expansion. So I've never played around with it. So I don't exactly know what happens to you if you get wet.
Well, I've just noticed now a new meter appeared there a minute ago. When it started raining under the sanity level, maybe you don't see it.
Yeah, I see it. I got it. All right, I found some berries, so I'm gonna go berry picking so we don't starve. And there's a turkey, and I can't catch the turkey because he is too fast for me. But I'm collecting more nuts. I'll be up there in a second. Don't worry.
Okay, I was heading out to see if I could quickly find more food, but we've. Picked the place pretty much bare now.
I found some more birch nut trees, so hopefully they will provide us with more for food. There we go. Nut. Okay. There's a pond here too, so we can fish later. Carrot. All right. This is good. All right. I need to drop something. I could drop these rocks.
A bird dropped some seeds for me.
Okay. Okay, and I will start heading back up to you when it is dusk. Another carrot. Yeah, we're not doing too well here. We might have to find that wormhole we went into and do some more foraging. I want to have a steady food supply. So I found the wormhole, but I won't use it yet. Oh, there's a frog.
Let's see, I'm trying to find the map here.
Amp should bring up the mini map. Get away from those seas birds, I need them.
I don't know if I'll actually see you on the map, or I just see myself.
How do I spot?
Okay, I see the wormhole is way down to my southwest.
Okay, I am...
Did you jump through it already?
No, I didn't jump through it yet. I was trying to find you. Where are you? Can we?
I'm way up to the. I'm still standing under that birch nut tree. Because it's raining, I might have to try to build a campfire.
Yeah, do you build a campfire? I will try to make my way to you. I think I know where you are. You're by the water, I believe, near the pig head. There you are. Okay, I got food. Oh, look, seeds. Get away from those seeds. Get away from the seeds. All right, I'm going to cook these. We should be okay. Because I'm hungry, too.
Yeah, left thing I can eat, the only thing I have left that I can eat are the flower petals.
Here you go. And now I'll cook these.
Oh, roasted berries, thank you.
No problem. All right.
I need that.
All right, I'll eat these. Oh, those trees are growing up pretty quickly.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Right before our eyes. All right, and I got some carrots. And... Alright, so I'll eat those. And I got a bunch of seeds. Ooh, look, more seeds. Give me those seeds. Alright, and then maybe we should just start heading back to the base after this and and come up with a new plan of attack.
Okay, so we have to eventually find a spider to get some parts that I can make an umbrella from?
Yes, yes. Do you need more food? Here's more food.
Because being the robot, thank you. The rain's not good for me.
No, not good for you. I think you might act as a lightning rod, too, because it says lightning regenerates you, doesn't it? I thought that was it.
It could be. Yeah, maybe.
Oh, jeez. Lightning is bad for me, unfortunately.
Guess what? It stopped raining.
Oh, good. Okay, I'm going to chop down this... I'll let it grow a little bigger. That I think when it reached maturity, it's when the... And it's going to get dark soon. Oh, look, seeds.
Yay. So let's try to find our camp again, because I kind of forget where it's at.
All right, follow me. I have a torch. Here's a torch. All right, let's stick close together. This torch...
Yeah, I'm following.
Okay.
So, how do you build a torch, and what is that under the survival?
It is under the light category. So if you go to your light category, you can build a torch.
Oh, I see. Okay, I'm going to build one. How do I light it now?
You put it in your hand. You put it in your
light. Oh, equip.
Yeah.
Okay, I see.
Exactly. All right, let's... this is creepy. I don't do this too often. I don't go out in the darkness too often.
Yeah.
It will go down. So do I have enough? Okay, let's just stay here for a little bit. Yeah, it goes down when you equip it. You see it percentage-wise, it will go down. So it's almost daytime anyways. And daytime. And daytime. There we go.
Oh.
All right. So, actually, it marks where we put traps on the mini map. So we could just follow the traps because those are close to our base.
Okay.
See those little baskets on the mini map?
I'm gonna look again.
Okay.
I don't see it right off, but I trust you.
Okay. All right. I've murdered a couple of rabbits. There was where that mushroom was. Give me my gold back. I don't know. Okay.
Is it best to drop the trap near a rabbit hole?
Yes. It's always better unless you can bait it. I don't even know where our science machine is. Where's our science machine? Oh, it's down there. Is it down there? It's down there. It's to the south. Okay.
Okay, yeah, I see it now.
Yeah, it's really hard because it kind of blends in with everything else. All right.
There's a pile of poop.
There's always a pile of poop near the beefalo. Okay. We got to start.
But at this point it won't do us much good until we build a farm or something?
We have to prototype the farm. So I'm going to start doing that, actually. Let's see what I need for the farm. Oh, look, seeds. Seeds for me. Give me the seeds. Thank you. All right, let's see what we need to prototype the farm. It's under food. Oh, I can build one right now. Excellent. All right, so I will make that. And then I can plant the seeds. And then for it to grow faster, you could use the poop on it. Fertilize. Fertilize. All right. And then I can make more... Well, I need to get more grass and more poop. So
is this a little farm area?
Yes, that's a farm area. For a farm, you need poop, you need logs, and you need grass. Which should be readily accessible to us.
I have one batch of seeds. Do I drop them here or no?
I already planted here, so let me get some more poop, because poop is the thing that we need. Thank goodness this isn't mating season yet. So if you look, if you stand next to the science machine, the food category lights up, and then you can prototype the farm.
Oh, okay. That's what I'm missing.
That's cool. So I'm just picking up some manure and more seeds.
Okay, it says for me I need to get 4 piles of poop before I can build a basic farm.
Ah, okay. So you're going to need poop. And I'm going to just start trapping everything because I have a lot of sticks.
Sounds good. I'm going to try to drop a couple more traps too.
And try to do it right over those holes. It'd be great.
I shall do that.
More poop.
Ah, okay. Bring on the poop.
Perfect.
I don't recall playing many games before where collecting poop is part of the game.
Yeah, it's a little weird. But once we upgrade the science machine, we can make a alchemy farm. I mean, an alchemy machine, which will make us a better farm.
Actually, I do recall another game I played was Farming Simulator.
Oh, that would work. Yeah, that's a thing.
You'd have to go in with your tractor with a scoop on it and move around piles of manure.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that's the only other game I recall where you had to collect poop.
Well, actually, in the South Park game, you can get poop from toilets. Yeah, that's and because in the South Park game they were kids playing a live action RPG, so they used everything around the environment, including fecal matter.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't watch South Park very often, so I don't know.
I think I might have watched it once, and it was like for me it was like, you know, it just wasn't my thing.
Yeah, some people like it, some people don't. I mean, oh, rabbit, awesome.
Yeah, obviously, different people are gonna have different interests or whatever. Obviously.
Yeah. All right, murdered a rabbit. I kind of feel bad for saying that. I feel really bad for saying that, actually. I don't like murdering cute little animals.
I think the thing is they kind of want you to make you feel a little bit guilty.
Because they like go when they die, and it's like, why are you doing this to me?
Why is this?
They also punish you in this game for murdering innocent creatures, too, because, so, not to scare you. So there's this thing, do you know the legend of, like, Krampus and the Krampus and the Christmas story?
No, I have not heard of that.
Okay, so the legend of Krampus in the Christmas story, first I want to find our base of operation so I can start heading towards it. So, you know, you have Santa Claus, who is this great guy who gives you gifts if you are, you know, if you're a good kid, right? And then you have Krampus, who is the guy who looks like a satyr, almost. And
is he something like Scrooge?
Not really. He looks like a satyr. So he looks like this creature with goat legs. And you've played Diablo. Do you remember the goat men in Diablo?
Okay, yeah.
He looks like that, except smaller. And he carries a wicker basket on his back. And he puts that wicker he puts a child who's been bad in the wicker basket, and he carries a whip of thorns. So he takes the child who's been terrible, brings him into the cold forest, and you better get up back here. I'm going to cook these so you have
I'm
food.
I'm here.
he brings them into the cold forest, and he whips them. And that's Krampus.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It sounds pretty bizarre.
Yeah. I want to say it's a Norwegian tale.
Yeah. You know, a lot, if you think about it, like a lot of the kids' fairy tales have kind of a really dark side to them.
Yeah, they do.
You know, like Hansel and Gretel and Little Red Riding Hood and... You know, even some of the old nursery rhymes like Ring Around the Rosies, Pocket Full of Posies.
Do you see that hand?
What is it? Yes, I did. What was it?
Yeah, that happens once in a while.
What was it?
It's us. It's just reminding us this place is weird.
I seen it coming at us and I said, uh-oh.
Oh, look, corn. Yay, we have corn.
Oh.
Now we plant more seeds.
Okay, I need to find
the seeds.
I need to find three more piles of poop. Come here, beefalo. Okay, now, I did set up a few traps, but the thing is I didn't have any carrots to put in as bait.
Yeah, we might have to herd them next to the trap, so let's see if we can do this.
Is it only carrots that you can use as bait for the trap?
I don't know, actually. Let me see. Yeah, you can bait them with seeds.
Like maybe berries or something?
Yeah, the seeds work, and the birds, I think, will go after them.
Oh, okay. Here's a beefalo.
Oh, look, all the poop.
Poop for me, beefalo. Poop. Okay, Okay, I think I have enough to build the basic farm.
Okay. Oh, goody. I have this cotter rabbit. And
I'll yay!
And then I'll murder that rabbit. I'll check aww that trap. And I'll murder that rabbit. And it sounds murder.
You know, this is an awesome game, though. I mean, it has a really unique cuteness to it, but it also has a almost dark dystopian side to it too.
Yeah, there is an end game with this game, because when you play single player, there's a guy who puts you here in the first place, and you eventually find that guy. I'm not going to spoil it for you because you might play single player one of these days. And it's just, it's dark. It's very dark. there's no other way to explain it. It's just very, very dark.
Well, you know what? I'm just enjoying the game for what it is now.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to enjoy the cuteness of it.
That's the spirit.
Okay, farm is... Oh, I have to be by the science machine to do the farm thing. Okay.
Yes. It will allow you to create a prototype.
Where is it? Basic farm! Ta-da!
Yay!
I'm going to build it down by our other little basic farm.
Awesome. And now you need to plant seeds. If you want your food to grow faster, you need more poo.
Okay, I think I used it all to build my farm thingy.
it's a vicious cycle of poop and stuff.
It is definitely, you know what, it is a pretty good game. My hat's off to the developers. I can see why it's become so popular.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I wasn't very surprised when they announced the starve together mode. That came after.
Guess what? I got a rabbit in a trap.
Yay! Now you can murder it and eat it.
Can I drop him?
Yeah.
No, I have to because my hunger level is like really dangerously low.
Okay.
So, I'm gonna have to cook them, I think. And...
Yeah, I'm gonna have to cook these guys too, unfortunately. Yeah, I need to make a ton more traps. So we just have like these rabbits at least are sustainable. They are sustainable food supply. All right, you're that way. And I'm getting really hungry, so I found more traps. Oh, here we go. Oh, there's one. Yep. Awesome. All right.
Let's see if I can build another trap or two here.
And murder. Okay.
Well, I can build one more trap.
Luckily, you know, you can pick them up and reuse them for a limited time. Oh, look, another one. We will feast tonight.
Well, it seems that you don't always need to bait the trap.
Yeah, sometimes they just run into it. So I'm going to just set it over here. Okay. And
yes, indeed.
Oh, seeds.
And I'm getting dangerously low on food again.
Okay, I got some, so let's just cook these bad boys.
Okay, you're right. I tried to eat a couple flower petals, and it didn't do anything for my hunger level. It did the heart flat.
Mm-hmm.
And other than that, I'm totally out of food.
All right, let me give you this, and I'm going to cook up some seeds.
Oh, very kind of you.
Don't worry. We got this. I should eat something, too.
You're very good for a human.
I am a meat bag. All right, here are these guys. All right, and I should start putting stuff away in this chest, too. Alright, and I'm going to plant these pine cones around here.
For a meatling, you're not bad.
And more seeds. Yeah, these guys are just dropping seeds for us. Alright, I'm going to just give the traps one more look-see.
Yeah, thank you. I think you helped me survive the night because I was all out of food.
It's all right.
Beefalo, now, can you actually, like, I'm not going to do it, but you can actually attack the beefalo and kill them for food?
Yes. We're probably going to need better equipment for that. I would like them to mate first, so they are a sustainable food source.
Okay.
Because I only see the pair of them, so when it's summer, they'll start having babies, and we'll be okay, and I should put some at you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I just noticed that. It's like, oh no!
Alright, that should keep going.
This game can be a little bit stressful, too.
It's kind of like it's a resource management type of game, so... You know,
but I'm digging it.
Yeah, I gotta eat. Alright, can I make another farm?
Something is coming!
Oh, okay, those are the goblin dogs. Okay, so our next priority should be... I should make another farm for us.
Yes.
Okay. And I gotta eat some seeds and... Alright, so our next priority should be to make weapons as soon as we get your hunger meter.
Like spears?
Yeah, so if you go to the fight category, you could prototype a spear, which I need to make some rope for the spear. And then I will make a spear. I need flint. I don't have flint. no, we're gonna die. We could fight them with axes.
Okay.
We can't.
You know what? I don't. No, maybe we should save it for the next episode.
Yeah, we should do that. All right.
Okay, but hey, we're into day 9, so that's cool.
Yeah, well, day 10, technically.
Well, I think because you're hosting the game.
Oh, I see.
When I join you, well, you're actually a little bit ahead in me for how much time you spent.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, it's showing day 9, but maybe for you, it's showing day 10.
Okay. All right. Yeah, we should...
What is that noise? It keeps saying something is coming.
Yeah, those are the goblin dogs. All right, we could leave now before that happens. So you can go first.
And... Let's finish this episode. Okay, I shall say, cook your carrots, and bye bye for now. Thanks for watching. Remember, I'm gonna post a link.
Oh no! Attack it!
Okay. What? Oh no.
I got you! Oh no, there's 4 of them! Take!
Okay.
Kite it!
Okay. Oh no, did we?
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah. Well,
okay.
I
well,
guess
this, I think this is the end.
Yeah, we might have to make a new world, and maybe now that we know what to do, we can do it better. Hey, you're like a ghost robot.
I'm a ghost robot. Okay, well, you know what? It's probably better to just start a new world next time because okay, you know, I was still really new to the game and didn't know quite what to do, but now we have a better idea what's going on.
Yeah. So day 10, the dogs. Sorry.
Okay, so I guess we'll leave it at that. Okay. Yeah, well, that was fun. That was interesting.
Mm-hmm.